Phenomenon. What's going on, guys? Karnak here, and welcome to another installment of Astroneer. It's been a little while since I put this game out. I'm doing this recording in my little off break that I was taking. I wasn't planning on recording anything based on the backlog that I have, but when I started editing videos, I noticed I didn't have any Astroneer, so I was like, yeah, you know, people are going to get kind of sick and not getting to see the good stuff. So, we are back with more Astroneer. I need to back my guy up because I took him off the oxygen tether. And I believe, if I remember correctly, we were facing some massive power issues. So we're going to have to figure out how to fix those. We also wrecked our truck somehow. Wonderful. Alright. So yeah, power problems. I did discover that there was some coal nearby, which means I was going to need some copper to make a generator. Right? Yeah, okay. And said generator would lead us to massive power production, which was going to be stored in the shit ton of batteries I was going to make with all this lithium I'm finding. Yeah, I think that's where we were last episode. Honestly, I have no idea. Probably should have watched the last episode, or at least the Cliff Notes version or whatever, to re-up on what I had done, but I'm a lazy fuck and didn't do it. So, we were trying to figure out our power problem. Now, if I remember correctly, there was a little bit of coal right here on the edge of the base that we were building. Although it does not appear as though there was much. Great. Although, all the coal in the world is not going to help if we don't have us a fucking generator. So, what did we figure out? How are we making... That's right. Sell some of the lithium. So the lithium. I can get me 2 copper. Did they nerf it more? Or shit's even less valuable than it used to be? Whatever. So, we'll sell that off for the 2 copper to make the generator. And sell another one of these for 4... or for 8, or for 4 compounds so we can get more power cells. Because I seem to remember discovering those things and how fucking wonderful that they are during the last episode. Still not going to help us. I'm really wondering if maybe if I, like, extend out the base way the fuck out that way. It's going to take a whole lot of resin to do so. If I extend the base way out here, will my happy little... Probably not. It does not look like I get much light at all. Okay, there's definitely some sunlight over here. But if I extend all the way out over here, will maybe my solar panel pick it up? See, like, there's just the barest... Oh, fuck. Whoa. That was lucky. No, fuck you, rock. Fuck you. Move. Yeah. Anyway, there's like the barest minimum of sunlight hitting the very top of my base right now. I'm wondering if that barest minimum is just enough to get my fucking solar charger or not. If the solar charger were in the right place. I'm pretty sure I saw it hitting the top of this battery, for instance. So, let's move. Okay. Now, see, that's something that's bothering me. It's bothering me a lot. There. See how that solar panel's getting hit by sunlight right now? Yeah, it's not opening up and collecting all that glorious fucking energy? You're shitting me. Right, but it's still not collecting anything. My game bugged? Are those trees over there really blocking the sunlight? I think they are. I think I'm actually having to take into account the shadows. Good on the game devs for it, but god, that's fucking annoying. Alright, let's bring them up here. You just sit there for a second, okay. Come on, baby. Just need you to get a little bit of juice. So it is looking like that maybe if I can get the thing high up enough and out of the way of these fucking trees, I might be able to actually gather a little bit of juice. Or up there. Huh. Maybe we should actually trade one of those for, instead of power cells, or compound, instead of compound, we trade for a little bit of that there resin. Start extending out our base. Okay, let's do that. So I've got to find a way to get more fucking regular power. Okay, I distinctly remember there being a power node right here. Did the game get an update? Am I missing something here? Son of a bitch. Okay, it's working. It is working. Okay, so I just needed a high enough point. Alright, that I can work with. Excellent. We are in business, ladies and germs. We are in business. This is not what I'm trying to do here. God damn it. Is that really another storm? Right now, I'm like on the verge of triumphing over a big problem I've been having. And you're gonna send a storm my way? Oh, that's the problem. I'm not hitting control. Oops. Let's try that again. Definitely need that second one, but we're closing in on being able to figure out this whole power issue that we've been having, which is fucking wonderful. I cannot begin to describe to you just how happy I am to see that my solar panels are finally working. Not without a lot of effort and a lot of heartache, but we finally figured something out that worked, so now we're better in business. I am going to go ahead and make a generator, just in case I do come across some coal, and we need it, or we can use it, but being that my space shuttle is powering up most of my base now without any trouble, God, that's so fucking wonderful. Especially wonderful considering my dumbass completely forgot to make a fucking solar panel. Let's go ahead and do that. Give me that back. Look at that. We have full fucking things. I mean, they're about to go down again, but we had full fucking things. Which is unusual for us. Oh god, this thing is it stuck in the ground? Not anymore, it's not. Alright then. Okay, let's fix this real quick. ground anymore. Alright guys, we are in much, much, much better position than we were like right at the start of this video, so I'm very happy with this. Okay, so our power problem has been figured. Why the fuck is that like that? Go away, please. Go away. Alright, but we do have us... I think I heard a compound coming back too, so let's go ahead and make us our, our new solar panel. With one on either side, now it should be able to get power at all times. I don't believe it took me this long to figure this out, but we figured it out, and that's what matters. So, now that I'm done being a dunce, telling y'all, it's just that redneck ingenuity. Yeah, sometimes it actually comes in pretty handy. We found a cave. However, the initial look is not one that's very promising. Looking like it might be a bit of an asshole of a cave. Yeah. Probably didn't spend enough time with his family, ignores his parents' calls, that kind of thing. Yeah, it's looking like one of those kind of douchebagging caves. We don't want a douchebagging cave. We want a cave that's going to provide us with all the lovely things in life. Namely, valuable fucking resources that I can then sell and trade for other more valuable resources. But, yeah. So, onward. Come in trios. I don't understand it. Then again, I don't have to. I'm just here to kill the funny looking things. Alright, so we got some resin and some copper though. That's a good start. More copper. Plenty of copper. Seems like copper is not going to be our problem here. What other secrets does this cage not want to divulge with its numerous little creeper thingies? That's hydrazine? Yeah. Okay. Not something I necessarily get excited over, but it's something tradable. I got a lot of shit down here, honestly. I should have put my truck down here. That's got a bad idea written all over it. This one looks like it's a series of dead ends. Fuck. I'll be back for all that later. See what's off in this direction, then, shall we? And this is looking like another dead end. Sometimes these dead ends have neat shit at the end of them. This is not one of those times. Alright, this is just a big fucking empty cave. but until I came in here, had not seen light of day in many, many eons. Wonderful. Yep, this was a douchebag cave. Parents haven't seen him in years. Doesn't talk to him. Oh no! Great. Now I'm falling through the world. Can I come back out? Thank you. I guess we'll explore upward too, but I feel like this is only just gonna leave me out. Which, I mean, handy I suppose. Not really, though. Yeah, I think that's the outside world. Great. Perfect. Found an extra way out of a cave that I didn't need to be in. So, really quick one to pop in. So, the net result of me finding that second cave system is huge. I'm going to have a lot of resources. So many, in fact, I'm going to have to actually make some storage units, bring them down there with me, so that way I don't have to run all the way back up here every time I get done fucking making shit. So, that's pretty fucking exciting, actually. It's not a problem that I've had before, the excessive amounts of resources. And I just managed to spend up all my tethers. I'm not going to need any more in most of the areas that I want to explore in that cave. I have our most of the areas that I want to explore in that cave, they've already been, oh wait, fuck, I didn't want to do that. I wanted to make a fucking habitat. Damn it. Well, they've already been, you know, done up, I guess is the best way to say it. But yeah. But, I have noticed two distinct, whoa! Why was it? Stop! No, stop! What are you doing? It's fucking weird. I've noticed two distinct things about the resources in this game. The way they work is that they stack on each other, and the veins are massive. Few and far between, but massive. Like, look at this shit. They're rolling in the resonant compound right now. What can I start on this planet? Power trouble. Initial power problems aside, this is fucking wonderful. Let's kill all these damn things. Or just fall into a big fucking hole, that works too, right? Yeah, come on, get out of the hole. Get out of the fucking hole. There we go. Alright, where'd that thing go? There you go. Dead. But yeah, like, this is stupid amounts of shit I'm finding. Right. Why have I got so much power? You go away. You go away. See, earlier I would have been killing for that, but now that I've gotten my power situation figured out, I ain't worried about nothing. Alright, so all this. But yeah, now, with this, I can effectively carry two backpack loads out at a time. See? Using my fucking noodle. It's not gonna be long before I'm not gonna really be able to do anything else in the game, and I'll have to stop making videos on it, and that's gonna really suck. But we do still have at least two more planets we have to go to, so won't be too soon from now that I'm gonna run out of shit to do. It's just gonna be sooner than I would have wanted. Hopefully the developers stay on top of you know, developing, and we actually get to keep seeing more content for this game come out. Cause it is a cool game. I love the terraforming, cannot English. I love the terraforming aspects of this game, as well as just the crafting system. Like, it's all really, really well done. It's just there's no real direct storyline. Like, there was a game I played a while back. I was intending on doing a series on it, and then just was kind of like, you know, it's boring now because I know everything that's going to happen. It's called Terra Tech, and that was one of the really big positive things about it, is that it was a really unique way of playing the game. But problem was, is it ran out of things to do very quickly early on. And they've made it a little bit better, where it's a little more, you know, there's a little more stuff to do, but not much. And it makes it boring quick. And I'm sad because there's one YouTuber that I watch, Smash Gaming, and he great guy, don't get me wrong, awesome YouTuber, but you know, he's focused so much on Terra Tech, and it's just, I mean, more power to him that he's still finding stuff to do with it, because quite frankly it got boring for me. And you know, spending 2 hours recording a video, then another 2 to 3 hours editing said video, looking at 20 minutes export a 30 minute video, and then about 30 minutes to upload it. So all in all, spending 5 hours to put out a game, to do something that I don't even like doing, it gets really boring really fast, and you get to the point where you're just dreading having to edit the video, because you're just like, there's not going to be any really good content in it. Yeah, there's not going to be any material that's going to just make you be like, wee, alright, cool, this is really fun to rewatch, you know? It's like all these Astroneer videos that I make, all the ARC videos I make, I have to relive whatever I did in those videos, and the more I get accomplished in each of those videos that y'all don't see is a lot of shit that I had to edit out. So yeah, I don't want to sit there and play a game that's going to get boring. And unfortunately, this one's closing in on it. Like, right now, in all reality, I could go to the next planet and be well set up. I mean, I found my aluminum cache down here, and I've got plenty of fucking compound and resin to start up a new base. Plus, I've got the giant fucking spaceship, so I'd be able to take more than enough stuff up there to get another base started. But I'm trying to see all the wonders these worlds hold for me before I do all that. I don't really know what else there is to do on this planet at this point. I figured we solved our major crisis. We figured out our power problem. And now look, you know, 3 batteries almost constantly getting some form of energy. There's a slight dead zone right now when it's sitting just below that horizon over there. Past that, no problem. So, I think that's what I'll do for now, is I'll start collecting resources to get ready to move over to the next planet. And this time, no poles bullshit. We're not dealing with that this time. I'm not going to another pole, because that power thing, while I found a solution, it was not fun finding said solution, because there was a lot of suffering that went into finding that solution. Let's see. Take one that's full of resin and one that's full of compound. Pretty simple. And then we'll take one that's half aluminum, half copper. Alright, that one's already up. You go on the spaceship. Probably gonna only take one of those solar panels with me for now. I'll still need a habitat. Might end up taking a battery, or, well, shit, I can make 2 trips. Look how fucking big that fuel tank is. Yeah, I'll take a battery. Okay, so solar panel, battery, thing full of resin, one full of compound, one half copper, one half aluminum, and I guess we'll head on to the tundra planet.
2 hours later.
And now, just like that, I've got a very solid startup supply amount for a new base. Oh, is my spaceship already full on fuel? Really? I was about to say. Give me something of a challenge, like, come on. Alright then. Alright, so I guess with that, we are gonna head off to the tundra planet. Base. We'll see you again sometime. I know it. Okay, something's up with the arid planet. What the fuck happened to it? That's strange. Yeah. Change of plans. We're going to the radiated planet. It was closer, and I'm impatient. That was a shitty fucking landing zone you picked there, fucking game. Jesus. Alright then. So as y'all probably figured out during my live stream, I am a smoker. And I was doing my best to keep it out of my videos, but for the most part, I just don't give a shit anymore because, quite frankly, I smoke. That's a thing I do. I do it in my little studio area. Got air purifiers at the yin yang and approval of the people that own this place that I can smoke in here, so I figure, why am I going to suffer any more than I'm already going to have to? God, this is a shitty fucking startup location. Seriously, like, I cannot get over how bad this is. I can't get a truck anywhere around over here without, like, serious amounts of undue stress. Can't connect these, can you? That's unfortunate. Alright. Over here. I've often wondered if you could kill one of these with a drill. our future studies, I guess. Alright, ladies and germs, it's about 2 a.m. now, so I'm gonna go ahead and, actually it's a little past 2 a.m. I'm gonna go ahead and call it a night there. I do appreciate y'all joining me for this. So we did manage to make it off of, we solved our power problem on the exotic planet. Now, I guess this planet's challenge is going to be making it where we can actually get a truck to traverse. So, that'll be, I guess that'll be next episode, is us actually building our vehicle bay, our truck, all that stuff, and then going from there. I do hope y'all enjoyed it. Please don't forget to leave a like. Subscribe if you haven't already. It does help me out a lot. Also, I would like to announce I have started a Patreon page. I know it might be a little early, but I figure if I wanted to go ahead and snag the username Cardoc before anybody got any bright ideas. So I've heard of that happening with other YouTubers. But, feel free to check it out. It's Cardoc221, just like everything else I've got. So if y'all would, I guess if y'all want to contribute, I would be very appreciative of that. But anyway, like I said, hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to leave a like, and I will catch all you guys in the very next one.